So, a while back, I made a video on how, even though marijuana is legal on certain state levels, it's still illegal federally. And that means someone can't legally own or have a gun if they make state legal weed. A lot of people weren't happy with my video because they were sure that the state government wouldn't cooperate with the feds to jail innocent people over pot. I've been saying, "I told you so," a lot lately. And Danny Trevino is another reason for me to say it. Arrested for selling legal weed in Michigan because, as I said, the state will use legalization as a trap for federal incarceration, he's going to prison for 16 years, with 4 years of supervisory probation. So let's talk about that. Let's start with the laws according to the National Organization for Reform of Marijuana Laws, or NORML. Quote, "Under Michigan law, marijuana is listed as a Schedule 1 controlled substance. An adult may possess up to 2.5 ounces of marijuana, up to 15 grams of marijuana may be marijuana concentrate. Within a residence, an adult may possess up to 10 ounces of marijuana and any marijuana produced by marijuana cultivated on the premises. An adult who possesses more than 2.5 ounces of marijuana within a residence must store the excess amount in a secure container. Possession of more than 2.5 ounces of marijuana and up to 5 ounces of marijuana is a civil infraction punishable by a maximum fine of $500 and forfeiture of the marijuana for a first offense. Possession of more than 5 ounces of marijuana is a misdemeanor. No term of imprisonment will be imposed unless the possession involved violence or was, quote, habitual, willful, and for a commercial purpose." We'll be using that a little bit later. Possession in or within 1,000 feet of a park is either a felony or a misdemeanor based on the judge's discretion and is punishable by a maximum of 2 years imprisonment and a fine of $2,000. They also have a chart where they go into just how much the state will fuck you for going over their arbitrary lines. But what's the issue the state claims for him specifically? Well, he ran 5 dispensaries and owned 100 total plants, but so do countless others in the region. From an MLive article, Danny said, "What was I doing that these others weren't? When they raided me, there were 88 dispensaries in Lansing. When the federal agent came to give me a tracking warrant for my car, we were standing across the street from one. We were 25 feet from another one and kitty corner from another one. What I asked him was this, when you were coming to raid Hydro World and you passed these other dispensaries, did you say to yourself, all these other ones are legal and Hydro World is illegal? He said, no, I passed them all and said all of them were federally illegal. So what makes his specific business subject to such high levels of scrutiny? Not much. But what excuse does the state have for forcibly caging a man for 16 years and ripping apart a family? The MLive piece continues, quote, "On top of that, court documents state Trevino leased space at his storefronts for other growers to sell marijuana, effectively creating a marijuana farmer's market. Trevino told MLive that he was aware that he was not legally allowed to be a caregiver, and he was not licensed to do so, but said that he always had enough employees on staff that were caregivers. Trevino is barred from being a caregiver due to previous drug convictions which occurred previous to legalization, but he got around this law by hiring only people who definitely were legal sellers, all with the proper status. His business was legal and constantly found to be so, with acquittals after every state trial. He stayed in business for years, despite being raided 26 times. He said, they're not really setting an example. They're just putting me away and that's it. They aren't taking any marijuana off the streets. They aren't stopping businesses like this from operating. It's just an ongoing fight. How do you get raided 26 times? How do you keep winning your cases and then get charged federally? So, what are the reasons given for a state agreeing to federal prosecution? What's their justification for turning the state law, which is allegedly designed to protect locals from the feds, on its head by working directly with federal prosecutors? U.S. Attorney Andrew Burge had this to say, quote, "Marijuana remains illegal under federal law.
Although Trevino has long claimed that what he was doing was legal, under the Michigan Medical Marijuana Act, he was not even close to being legal, and made a mockery of the Michigan Medical Marijuana Act in the process. Trevino had ample opportunity to realize the illegal nature of his business under both the federal and state law, given the number of times his operations were searched. He would not stop. Perhaps he will get a better understanding of the law behind bars.
So, why were all the others passed up then? His mother and hundreds of others are sure it's racism. That theory has some merit. With the state government's cooperation with the feds in Operation Wetback, no, I'm not joking, a mass deportation of workers illegally abused by entrenched corporations after the minimum wage was enacted, and the state's previous endorsement of the importation of Texican workers, it's clear to see that only Hispanics serving state interests and towing the line are welcome. With all the white-owned dispensaries and with Hispanics making up a tiny fraction of the total population, it makes some sense to think they wanted to send a message about who's allowed to run this kind of business. Yeah, he'd be in violation if those were all his plants, but that's like saying eBay owns what's sold there. Ridiculous. He ran what amounts to a bazaar, and he's being treated like a kingpin. From MLive, I'm being looked at like a cocaine dealer, a heroin dealer, and a meth dealer, he said. They're selling licenses left and right. They have me guilty for 100 plants, but Michigan is selling licenses for 1,500 plants medically. Recreational is coming, and I'm hearing of places like Muskegon that are going to open up with an unlimited plant county. How is it that I'm illegal? Given the massive racial disparities that exist and have existed in terms of sentencing for the same things, it makes a matter of sense to think that they're doing what they've always done, use laws which apply to everyone to abuse the few. So the state kept losing, over and over, and eventually decided to sell them out to the feds when their laws weren't good enough. Expect to see those laws changed, by the way. He's ripped from his daughter, who will grow up fatherless. He's caged for 16 years and fined $1,100 and forced on supervised release after he's out for 4 more years. A man who helped people sell plants which are legal in his state, plants in which the founders of the country indulged, is going to the same prison which houses murderers, rapists, and thieves, and given a longer sentence than many of those people. For helping people get their medicine, and dramatically boosting the local economy. He's being treated as a social deviant. U.S. District Attorney Judge Paul Maloney said states are changing marijuana laws across the country. Certainly that's true, but federal law has not changed. After years of fighting his assets stolen from him and years of being forced into trial after trial only to win them all, the state government decided the opinion of the feds was more important than the rights of Michiganders. Either way, whether this is racism or just a guy being abused for a victimless offense, it highlights something. The idea that your state is here for your rights is only a carrot they hang in front of you, so you remain on the hamster wheel of obedience. They don't give a fuck about your liberty, and they don't legalize to do anything more than have more technicalities upon which to hang you. Someday, hopefully, people will realize this. Someday, hopefully, they'll stop caring about the opinion of feds and defend liberty, human rights, and justice, no matter who's asking. A man is caged for selling something which harms nobody. The ACLU also said in 2010 that a pot arrest happens every 37 seconds, and that this $3.6 trillion industry of jailing peaceful people is primarily used against black people, even though they smoke about as much as whites. Drugabusestatistics.org says that of the 600,000 plus people arrested yearly for pot possession, about 100 people are federally imprisoned yearly for marijuana possession, and nearly 60% are Hispanic. And while sources discussing it say that trafficking is the primary reason for these people being caged, why is moving a product voluntarily produced, sold, and consumed illegal? Why does the state get to play morality police? For a country with freedom of religion, this one is among the most puritanical anywhere, at least when their piety profits them. Because let's be clear, This is about wealth and power, not protecting people. Danny hurt nobody, and they caged him like an animal. The state is a gang, and he stomped on their turf, so they stepped up and showed him they ain't the crew to fuck with. Stateies couldn't get him, so they called Big Daddy Feds up so they could sort the sitch out for them. Thug-ass hammers looking for nails, they found a family man selling harmless plants, shredded his freedom, and destroyed his daughter's childhood. And they want to act like the good guys? Correct me if I'm wrong, but the good guys don't normally destroy families and lives over harmless shit. But hey, maybe I'm just old school, and I think good fathers should be in the lives of their daughters. And maybe a plant the founders of a country smoked shouldn't be the basis for that country to kidnap people. And maybe it should be even sentencing, and the content of their character and effect of their action should be the reason they're deemed unfit for society, rather than the color of their skin. But until people realize this basic shit, people like Danny will languish in cages while their communities are destroyed. And no amount of state authorization will protect you if the state put you in crosshairs. So just remember that the next time something is legalized. Words on paper don't stop tyrants. And if you really want your liberty protected, might have to take matters into your own hands. Because there are still redcoats around, abusing and usurping, and they don't care what you write, or who helps you pass what. They're here on the take, and they only speak one language. Know what I'm saying? Or you could just focus on impeachment. I'm sure your liberty is less important than a political soap opera.